Nearly 800 researchers from several dozen campus departments work within the massive Beckman Institute. They focus on a wide range of fields, including computer science, chemistry, psychology, electrical engineering, and physics. Beckman's three interrelated main research themes are biological intelligence, human-computer intelligent interaction, and molecular and electronic nanostructures.
The Beckman Institute should be a world-class, leading-edge, interdisciplinary research institute. Above all, that means that the scientific research should be first-rate. But beyond that, I want the institute to serve as a model for universities and their departments to grow beyond their traditional discipline-based structure.
Researchers in the biological intelligence area try to understand the many ways in which neurally based systems become capable of intelligent behavior. Biological intelligence co-chair Bill Greenow has been at the Beckman since its inception. He studies neural mechanisms underlying learning and memory. His research is partly focused on the Fragile X syndrome, the largest genetically inherited cause of human mental retardation. He collaborates with other researchers to investigate therapeutic intervention and recovery from alcohol-related brain damage, the largest cause of mental retardation in the U.S.
Our work is very much impinging upon what underlies that syndrome and potentially what kinds of routes we might go in to find a cure.
Jonathan Sweetler came to Illinois specifically to do his research at the Beckman Institute. He studies how neurons in the brain chemically react with one another, a place between chemistry and neuroscience. He's convinced Beckman's interdisciplinary approach produces results.
No other university I've looked at actually has something like the Beckman, where this type of really cross-department interdisciplinary research, where you have graduate students from many disciplines working together, is, you know, it's easier at the Beckman Institute.
Researchers in Beckman's human-computer intelligent interaction theme examine the interplay between machines and humans. Researcher Sharisa Lansing is part of the Beckman team studying language production. In addition to her work on the Intelligent Hearing Aid Project, she's trying to help the hearing impaired by looking at visual cues. Where do good communicators look when someone else is talking? She says Beckman's interdisciplinary approach to research is vital.
When you cross disciplines, you're put in a very exciting situation because, one, you need to communicate ideas from one perspective and you learn about other perspectives.
Imagine a computer knowing your emotions and acting for you. In co-chair Tom Wong's laboratories, it is becoming reality. Wong is part of a team of engineers, computer scientists, and psychologists building a computer which tracks a user's face and determines emotion. It might then suggest programming options. Yet another project involves creation of a database of digital multimedia images.
The idea is the computer should not be just passively carrying out commands, but try to help the user to accomplish his or her task by taking initiatives.
Research in the molecular and electronic nanostructures theme is focused on new materials, fabrication methods, and a theoretical understanding on the smallest scale. In Nancy Soto's lab, that means studying the mechanics of materials. In this case, development of a plastic that can heal itself after it cracks. Soto's is collaborating with chemists, material scientists, and engineers. She believes the applications in aerospace, medicine, and microelectronics are enormous.
Basically, if there are cracks or the material is damaged under normal use conditions, it generates new material and heals the crack autonomically without any human intervention of any kind, much like your autonomic nervous system.
Molecular and electronic nanostructures co-chair Jeff Moore is also working with small-scale chemistry that could bring big research results. In collaboration with other Beckman Institute researchers, Moore wants to develop autonomous biological substances that know how to respond to change. He knows Beckman's interdisciplinary approach is the key.
It is both stimulating to be learning from your collaborators and also to try to stimulate them by providing an accelerated pace of research. I think that's really what it's about.
Beckman's research resources are outstanding. In Beckman's Visualization, Media, and Imaging Lab, research teams can work on their own or with guidance with a full range of imaging services to produce video, slide, digital, transparency, and journal presentations. The other half of the imaging technology group is the microscopy suite. It features a wide variety of the very best microscopes, optical, electronic, and scanning probe. The Integrated Systems Laboratory at the Beckman Institute is a facility where researchers from the Human-Computer Intelligent Interaction main research team perform the integration of advanced technology and conduct experiments in human perception and cognition. The newest addition, this six-sided virtual reality cube named Alice, the adaptive laboratory for immersive cognitive experiments. There is no doubt the Beckman Institute for Advanced Science and Technology is breaking scientific barriers. The best facilities and support staff, combined with ongoing rejuvenation of projects and constantly stimulating scientific minds, have the Institute at the front of the research curve.
This Institute is the vision of Illinois native Arnold Beckman. This giant in scientific instrumentation always wanted to see the best researchers challenging each other, pushing science to once unreachable levels. That dream has become reality in an institute that bears his name.